I'm Megan Gerben. I'm the Clinical Nurse Supervisor at AmeriStaff Nursing Services. Today, we're going to talk about screening and going back to work, what this may mean for you in Oakland County, according to Whitmer's year plan. So the major things is, you know, what's going to be on this? What's going to be expected of me when I'm going back to work? A lot of people already going out into the community, you've noticed that you're being asked to wear a face covering, a face mask, something along those lines. Lots of different options here, different grades. Depends where you work. If you're a nurse, you may be, you know, asked to wear something a little bit more, like, you know, this beautiful N95 that I wear going out to see patients. According to the plan, it just says face covering if you're within 6 feet of other people. Now, if you are within 3 feet of other people, they're talking about wearing a face shield. And what this means is something along these lines, you get to be in a bubble. It's not that bad. I wore one yesterday while seeing another patient with two masks underneath and did just fine. Now, other options you have to wear out in the community and at work, you have your surgical mask, or if you know nice people that sew for you, boop, you get some beautiful little ones that have like nice pattern on it. Now, there are other YouTube videos and all sorts of stuff that show you how to make them out of bandanas, all that type of stuff. I highly suggest finding out from where you're going to prior to going out so that you don't have to turn around and go back home, especially if you're going to be returning to work. Find out from your employer what they expect you to be wearing and if they will actually be providing that for you. Now, one of the big things is temp checks. It is mentioned in the tier plan to check temperatures, not necessarily because if they don't have a thermometer or one that's safe to use, then they may not do that. They may ask you to check your own temperature prior to coming in, or they may check you as you're coming in. What this may look like is something simple like this, where it's just, shoot, 98.7. I'm beautiful today. Now, some corporations that are home care based or a nursing base, we're going out into the community, into some corporations, we're wearing the full getup and we're testing you guys as you guys return to work. It may be a little bit of a questionnaire that you're going to fill out. Simple questions. Have you been tested? Have you tested positive? What were those dates? Do you have any signs and symptoms? We'll run through the whole thing for you and make that decision for you. So it just kind of depends where you're working, where you're going. Now, if you're not returning to work and you're going out to a business, again, highly suggest calling that business, checking in first. Some of them are going to be checking prior to you going in. If you have a meeting, they may have you stop off and do a little checkpoint with some sort of screener and just double check you prior to coming in. Make sure you're not gonna, you know, spread anything around. Does take a little extra time. It depends what type of corporation you're going to. Some of us nurses, we can fly through, you know, a good 40 people because we have these point and click, you know, thermometers that are nice and fast. Other patients, you know, people don't have that technology and it takes a little bit longer. So you always wanna give yourself a little extra time as you're going out and kind of add that in. I highly suggest reading the tiered plan. There's lots of different levels as to when things are going to be opening and not dates. Depends on like where we're at with our curve. But finding out, you know, what types of businesses are going to be open, who's going to be allowed in there. Is it only the essential employees that are allowed back in? Or can other people, you know, go visit those as well? And again, go online, call them, find out what you need to use prior to coming out there so you're not wasting time. If you have any questions, you can call us over at AmeriStaff, 248-288-2270. You can always email us as well at nursing@americaremedical.com. Thanks and have a wonderful day.
Hello, I'm Greg Jamian, and thank you for watching Boomer Health at Home, the show where we explore the most relevant healthcare topics impacting the baby boomer generation today. As more and more baby boomers seek answers to many times difficult healthcare questions, our goal is to provide ideas, tips, and cutting-edge solutions that will help improve your everyday life and health. It is our hope that you find the following information helpful as you sit back and watch Boomer Health at Home.